take a look at this photo sent in by viewer Lee Newman. This is a water spout he caught at around 7:45 today at Sunset Point in Mandeville. That's the causeway in the background. Remember to send us your photos or upload them to our local site on WDSU.com. We might show them on TV. We had at 5 o'clock a viewer in Grand Isle. I think we had a water spout that we showed. So that extreme weather and the changes, that always produces visions like that.
Well, we get these strong thunderstorms, and then when they move over the water, they produce these water spouts. But when we watch these water spouts, the big key is whether or not it's going to make it over land. Then we're talking about a tornado, and that could be much worse. But I want you to be careful when you're sending in these photos.
Right.
Be far away from these water spouts.
Right.
Absolutely. And we could be seeing a few more of these water spouts tomorrow. We're seeing those same conditions for the rest of tonight and throughout your Sunday like we had earlier today. So that's something to keep in mind if you're heading out to the water. Maybe some strong storms to deal with for tomorrow, especially in the afternoon. As we look at the radar, this is the big picture. We've got a stationary boundary located to our north, basically hovering over the central part of the country. And then we've got an area of high pressure located to our east and southeast. And basically what's happening with the stationary front off to the north, we're getting these little disturbances that kind of hang around the area and move over us. And that's what's happening right now. So you can still see that we have a little shower activity, even some thunderstorm activity. I want to zoom in a little closer north of the lake. We're seeing a rather strong storm for this evening right here just to the east of Mandeville. You can see there is a lot of lightning associated with this storm, also some heavy rain, and I wouldn't be surprised if there's some gusty winds. Now, the hail potential has decreased. It was a little bit stronger just a few moments ago, maybe up close to an inch in diameter, so maybe quarter-size hail, but it looks like it's going down just a tad, so some good news there, but I am seeing a lot of lightning with this storm, so you'll probably want to stay indoors if you do live in southern and central St. Tammany Parish until this storm continues to make its way out of the area. We're seeing a little shower activity in the southern half of the area as well, so I'm going to keep about a 30 to 40% chance for some isolated showers and storms for the rest of tonight. Let's talk about tomorrow. What can you expect in the morning time? I think we'll see some clouds, but also maybe some isolated showers and storms, and then the storm chances will linger on into the afternoon. So no changes there. You can see around 3 o'clock, we've got some storms pushing into the area, and you can see right here over the metro, we are looking at some more storm chances, very similar time frame as what we had today. And then as the sun goes down, we won't be as unstable. So I think by late tomorrow evening, things will start to quiet down, but we do have to keep those storm chances in the forecast for the start of the work week. How about temperatures this evening? Well, temperatures really today weren't too bad, especially in the southern half of the area. We had a lot of cloud cover and showers earlier this morning along the coast. The high at the airport today was only 88 degrees. That's cooler than average, so the cloud cover and the rain-cooled air help things out. We're currently at 81 in New Orleans, 81 in Belle Chasse. Heat index, it's out there, not as strong as it can be for this time of year, so some good news there for your evening plans. Let's talk about the temperature forecast for tomorrow. Morning time temperatures into the mid to upper 70s. Highs tomorrow afternoon, very close to 90 degrees, and I think that's where we're going to be for the next several days. So take a look at this consistent forecast. Really no major changes, not really going to be fluctuating too much with our temperatures or our storm chances. I do think for Thursday, I want to watch that very closely, that stationary boundary that I was mentioning earlier in my weathercast. Well, that's going to get even closer to the area, so I think our storm chances could be going up later in the week, but really just a consistent forecast, Rachel. No changes on there, but good storm chances each day all week long.
Gray and gloomy. That's the